Hello and welcome to another episode of Ezoic Explains. I'm Whitney Wright, and today we're going to be talking about the new Core Web Vitals metrics that Google has announced that will be implemented within the next 6 months. Google recently announced that there will be upcoming changes to Search Console by incorporating Core Web Vitals as new metrics that broaden how Google measures speed and website performance. Google has openly said that they will affect search ranking. These new metrics can be found in Google Search Console. What was previously the Speed Report is now the Core Web Vitals tab. The tab is pulled from the Chrome UX Report, which is also known as CRUX. So firstly, what are Core Web Vital metrics? The Core Web Vitals are a set of metrics related to speed, responsiveness, and visual stability to help site owners measure user experience on the web. The three factors that make up the Core Web Vitals are loading, interactivity, and visual stability, which are measured by largest contentful paint, LCP, first input delay, FID, and cumulative layout shift, CLS. Some of these performance metrics are common to publishers, like first input delay. Metrics like largest contentful paint and cumulative layout shift were essentially coined and created by Google, so you might not have heard of them before. CLS is a website loading metric for measuring visual stability. It aims to quantify how often users experience unexpected layout shifts. In the eyes of Google, a low CLS helps ensure that the page functions properly for users. Their good range is less than 0.1 seconds. Here is an example of a page that likely has a high CLS. The user places their cursor over the no go back selection, and just before they click, the layout shifts, and yes, place my order is accidentally chosen. This makes for poor user experience. Unexpected movement of page content usually happens because resources are loaded asynchronously or DOM elements get dynamically added to the page above existing content, such as images or videos with unknown sizes, fonts rendering, or third-party ads that dynamically resize. A big cause of this is that a website might look different to a user than one of the website developers. Images and other elements are often already in the developer's browser cache, and API calls that run locally are often so fast that the delay or shifts aren't noticeable. First input delay measures the time between when a user first interacts with your site, i.e. when they click on something, to the time the browser is able to respond to the interaction. The good range is less than 100 milliseconds. If you're a WordPress site, FID increases are probably coming from your plugins and any external JavaScript calls. WordPress plugins for speed can also slow down your FID score, since they often make external calls and then slow your site down. LCP is measuring the perceived load speed to the visitor. It was, and arguably still is, calculated best by looking at DOM interactive, but now Google is looking at this interaction a bit differently. Most of what impacts this metric are above the fold images, video players, and other media that takes time to load prior to the portion of the page the user sees and interacts with. So Google wants to ensure that everything a user is going to see when they land on the site is visible quickly and doesn't jump around. To optimize LCP, consider if you have any of the following: a floating newsletter or subscription signup bars, floating social media widgets, social media icons that load above the fold for article sharing, newsletter, login, or widgets that load in the visitor's viewport of an article, videos that load above the fold, images above the fold, author boxes that are auto-injected with pictures on the page. Site speed optimizations can also affect LPC if they require the execution of lots of JavaScript. If the tools are delivered via plugin or by adding a snippet of code to the header of your site, it is worth evaluating how much these tools may actually be hurting your FID or LCP scores. You might be wondering what the difference is between LCP and FCP, or first contentful paint. So LCP takes into account things like media and video, and when the user sees what the actual page is going to look like, even if it's going to load other things in the background. And then FCP is when the user first actually sees your content. FCP is then a part of LCP. You can see this in Google PageSpeed Insights if you run a URL through. So how do we optimize for each of these metrics? The best way to speed up CLS is to lazy load images and ads. But when you do, you want to make sure the pixels for the location of those items are set. For example, as the content loads in a GIF, all the places for ads and images are already defined. If an image hasn't loaded yet because the user scrolls really fast, it doesn't move around. It would just be a blank white space until you're ultimately able to load the image. This makes it so your content doesn't jump around, but loads around these spaces before the images or videos ever show up. There is a full guide online that I'll include in the video description, along with some JavaScript code that you can wrap your images with so they have enough padding to prevent this jumping. If you use Ezoic's ad tester, the ads that appear on your website are already padded correctly to where your site's content won't jump around for the user once they're scrolling. To improve LCP outside of just lazy loading, try to load thumbnail previews of videos instead of full videos on your page. If you use WordPress, there are a number of tools and plugins that allow you to load YouTube iframes as a preview image, and the user has to click to load instead of the video loading upon page load. WordPress has also some natively supported features for this. You also want to make sure your images are small files and compressed. A good rule of thumb is to make sure your images are less than 100 kilobytes. It is recommended to resize and optimize your image yourself because most images can be decreased to 40 kilobytes or less. Also for mobile, images don't need to be more than 650 to 800 pixels wide. You can also load images in next-gen formats, which will help your website. Next-gen formats are image files that hold compression information that web browsers can read so things load faster, though not all browsers can load them. FID time can be reduced by making sure you add as little JavaScript that delays anything from loading in your website's header as possible. Any additional unnecessary JavaScript you can remove from your site, the better. Look at your website's header code and WordPress plugins to see if you can deactivate any of them or defer them so they are only active on pages that they are actually used. So how important are these metrics? Google rarely tells us when something affects ranking, and since they have told us core web vitals will become a factor, they're relatively important. UX for Google is different from UX for a publisher. Google determines good UX by if something best fulfills a search result. They do also care about the user's overall experience with your site, though, which is where core web metrics come in. Google will use this data when they are trying to evaluate two very similar results. If all other things are equal in terms of content, Google will likely use something like the core web vitals to make an ultimate determination. Google claims some of the best ways to improve core web vitals are to reduce your page size to less than 500 kilobytes, limit the number of page resources to 50, and consider using AMP. Ultimately, try to trim as much fat as possible from your website, especially plugins. Ezoic Site Speed Accelerator does every site speed optimization you could ever get from plugins, but it's all in one tool. But as you already probably know, and what we will continue to say over and over, is that content is king. Your number one priority should always be on writing good content that will rank in the first place. You can't compete with core web metrics if your content is not good enough to rank. Focus on providing something valuable to users and let everything else be secondary. And that's it for this episode of Ezoic Explains. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, please subscribe to our channel. Please subscribe to this playlist, Ezoic Explains. If you'd like to find us on LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, you can find us there. We're on ezoic.com. We also have a blog at ezoic.com/blog. This has been another episode of Ezoic Explains.